Schwanz!
The best thing about sex is an orgasm.
The feeling of euphoria as you're coming.
Well, I think the orgasm.
The longer you wait, the better it is.
But hang on, the foreplay is pretty good too. I like it being done to me, but I don't like doing it, you know.
Well, it's slippery when it's wet.
Sharing a loving feeling. Is that it?
Yeah.
Sharing something anyway.
Two women. Just doing whatever.
Cal, what isn't good about sex? You know, it really depends on how you look at it.
I think it's a gift that we got from God. And I'd like to thank her right now.
No matter how you look at it, sex, one of humanity's oldest, simplest, and best documented activities, continues to be a very hot topic, perplexing and bedazzling each new sexually active generation. Standards and mores may change, and sexual technology too. But today, as in every age past, the conflicting ways in which we look at sex and the values we bring to it continue to divide and plague us. AIDS, for example, once an affliction that barely dared speak its name, is now the concern of star-filled benefit events and charity albums. But war in the Middle East may have overshadowed an ominous AIDS milestone. A January announcement by the Centers for Disease Control that the U.S. AIDS death toll has now topped 100,000, and that figure may reach as high as 300,000 by the end of 1993. If that sounds scary, it is.
I think everyone thinks that they'll find a cure, but I mean, you know, what if they don't? Ever.
Apart from abstinence, the only answer to AIDS right now, it seems, is safe sex, a practice which has found some of its most outspoken proponents among young musicians.
Hey, you! Don't be silly! Put a rubber on your willy!
Well, basically, safe sex is sexy.
Actually, I'm into kind of violent sex, but I mean, it, you know, still like it's safe.
But if you're gonna screw, use a condom.
And they got the new ones in the
Magnum
blue box.
The Magnum.
No, they green. They green.
Aqua blue.
Extra large.
Safe sex requires condoms, of course, and yet when New York City Schools Chancellor Joseph Fernandez recently proposed distributing condoms to students who requested them without parental consent, he stirred up a firestorm of controversy. This in a city with the nation's highest teenage AIDS rate, and at a time when half of all boys are having sex by the age of 16 and half of all girls by age 17. The Fernandez plan finally passed, but by only one vote.
I vote yes.
Many parents protested that free condoms would promote teenage sex.
As if teenage sex needs promoting. I mean, please.
Teens are having sex, and like if parents haven't noticed that by now, then like they're on drugs or something.
I think kids should get sex education. I think condoms should be available. You don't have to pass them out, but they should have them maybe at the health office. You know what I'm saying? Like a box. You could go get them if you wanted them.
Condoms aren't altogether the safest thing. The safest thing is not having intercourse. Otherwise, you take the chance of dying. And that's a serious thing, you know? You can't. Ramifications of death are final.
I don't want to die alone. That's a real feeling that a lot of us have. I met my present boyfriend a little under a year ago. It's been a relationship that I hope is going to last a long time and hopefully the rest of my life, if that is a long time. There are some people, you know, their jaws drop when I tell them that I have a happy and healthy sex life and that I'm HIV positive. The assumption being that if you're HIV positive, you should never have sex again. This is the year of I've had three or four boyfriends since 1985, all of whom have been HIV negative, and I've had active sexual relations with all of those boyfriends, and all of them to this day are HIV negative. So I think that proves the point that safe sex works. There are all sorts of feelings that we're both grappling with. And it takes some real work and real trust and a lot of love to get beyond that and to have a positive, enjoyable sex life. My idea of sexual morality is two consenting adults doing whatever they want. Enjoy yourself, that's what I say. You know, you only got a certain amount of time. Most people got probably a lot more time than I do. But still, you don't know that for sure. So maybe we should all be afraid of time. It's important to really enjoy it while you can. Get rid of it. Get rid of the guilt.
Oh,